Now that we've looked at the overview of calcium homeostasis, let's take a look at hypercalcemia and all the different pathologies associated with it. Abnormal elevation of serum calcium. First step, workup. Is it confirmed the elevation? And always check to see as to what your free ionized calcium is, because that would be the functioning form. Calcium is 40% bound to albumin. It requires a chaperone. Remember, overall calcium in the ECF is a very, very small percentage. 99% of your calcium is actually in your bone. Remember that calcium, and majority of it, in fact, is in ECF. Therefore, any time there's a channel that's opened up for calcium, it'll then rush in. Adjust the total calcium, what's total mean to you, the bound plus the free or the ionized. Always, what is it that makes majority of your total? It's the bound. Adjust total calcium up to 0.8 milligrams per deciliter for every gram by which serum albumin is below 4 grams per deciliter. Alkalosis increases calcium binding to albumin, whereas acidosis decreases it. And that's an important point. At some point in time, we'll talk more about acidosis and the activity of osteoclasts and so forth. But at this point, understand that alkalosis increases calcium binding to albumin. The more that positive cation calcium will bind to albumin when there's alkalosis state in your plasma. Hypercalcemia, acute. What kind of issues might the patient then have? Anorexia, nausea, vomiting, constipation. CNS, there'll be confusion and weakness. Hyporeflexia versus tetany. There's no muscle twitching in hypercalcemia. None. If anything, hyporeflexia. Cardiovascular, hypertension, shortened QT, not lengthened. Occasional brady, and maybe perhaps first degree AV block, you're looking for prolonged, permanent prolongation of your PR interval. In the kidney, may be associated with polyuria polydipsia, especially if you're thinking about nephrogenic diabetes insipidus, and may result, or prerenal azotemia, decreased filtration, resulting in hypercalcemia. These are issues that you're looking for, clinical manifestations of hypercalcemia. Chronically, the mnemonic that you probably have come to become familiar with, stones, bones, groans, and psychic overtones, pretty much tells you the problems that you would have with chronic hypercalcemia. Stones, calcium stones, being the most common, calcium oxalate, bone issues, groans, pain, and psychic overtones, osteoporosis with bone pain, and nephrocalcinosis with stones. It will be band keratopathy, deposition of calcium phosphate in sun-exposed cornea, keratopathy. You have chondrocalcinosis, meaning to say that in the bone, by the epiphyseal plate, you would have accumulation of calcium. Calcium, hypercalcemia, may actually bring about damage to the pancreas. You've heard of saponification, and may cause hypercalcemia and hypertension.